안녕하십니까. Now, I think that the very important moment that we are facing to the dangerous situation in Asia. And especially it is very important Korea peace action. Because we are now big danger of the nuclear weapon threat and at the same time, the crisis of the climate. The peace is very holistic. And of course, the peace is very important, no war. But on the other hand, we have to create that sustainable world together in a sustainable Northeast Asia. And otherwise, that we cannot expect that a peaceful and fruitful future in our region. Let's work together. Let's tie together and solidarity for peace in Korea. That's our goal. Thank you. Let's work together.
Dear ecumenical friends and colleagues, the Christian Conference of Asia stands in solidarity with the Korean people on the 71st anniversary of the Korean War Armistice and the observance of Korea Peace Day, scheduled for 27 July. As the voice of the churches and the ecumenical movements in Asia, CCA takes this opportunity to reiterate its support for the people in the Korean Peninsula and their aspirations for peace with justice, reconciliation, and reunification of the divided Korea. As we all know the fact that the division of Korea into North and South more than 7 decades ago symbolizes one of the most painful political and ideological tribulations of the Cold War era. While the Christian Conference of Asia appeals for the immediate cessation of all hostilities, we believe that every effort towards preventive diplomacy through meaningful dialogue will diffuse military tensions and reduce nuclear risks. It is also imperative that communication channels among the people and communities be opened in the divided Korean Peninsula. The CCA reiterates its support for Korean churches in their repeated calls for a permanent peace treaty to replace the 1953 armistice. On this occasion, the Christian Conference of Asia urges all Christians across Asia to continue to pray for peace, reconciliation, and reunification of the divided Korean Peninsula. Let us pray for the leaders and citizens of both nations that they may be guided by wisdom and compassion in their pursuit of lasting peace. May God Almighty bring unity and peace in the Korean Peninsula.
안녕하십니까. I'm Jennifer Debert with the American Friends Service Committee. I'm sorry I could not be with you in person today, and I wish to express my solidarity for this gathering of people pushing for peace and an end to a war that still affects the lives of many, even after more than 7 decades. Founded in Quaker values, American Friends Service Committee believes in pursuing a just peace with dignity for all, especially in places of conflict. Advocating to the U.S. government for an end to the war and policies that increase possibilities for people-to-people contact has long been a staple of our work, based on our decades of cooperation with partners in the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. We see strong support among people in the U.S. with polling data revealing public support for the U.S. to take actions to cooperate with the DPRK, including ending the war, working for family reunions, and allowing people-to-people exchanges. Of course, none of us can alone reach the future we wish to see. And I'm grateful to the organizers for bringing together people who carry the same dreams for a different future, and look forward to continuing in solidarity. 감사합니다.
안녕하십니까. 저는 미주 한인평화재단의 문유성입니다. 저는 먼저 7월 27일 정전 71주년을 맞아 임진각에서 진행된 한반도 평화행동의 평화대회에 참가하시는 여러분들에게 연대 인사를 전합니다. 저희 미주 한인평화재단은 7월 22일부터 뉴욕 맨하탄 타임스퀘어 대형 전광판에 코리아의 평화를 염원하는 영상을 올리고 있습니다. 영상은 첫째 평화협정 체결, 종전선언, 휴전 71년은 너무 길다는 메시지로 이루어져 있습니다. 아울러 워싱턴 DC에서 미국의 평화 애호가들과 함께 평화 집회를 개최하고 있습니다. 지금 한반도는 군사 충돌이 어느 때 어느 장소에 일어나도 놀라지 않을 정도로 군사 긴장도가 높습니다. 저희는 한반도 평화 행동의 여러분과 함께 한반도의 평화를 위해 꾸준히 연대하겠습니다. 감사합니다.